of all, let me congratulate you for this amazing debut album.
Thank you.
And for this nice show. You've been okay playing there? You feel happy?
Yeah, I feel great. That was such a fun show. I've never had people clap during the breakdown of my Maybe Don't Understand Me before, and everybody like has rhythm, and it was great. It was just amazing. Now I feel really good about it.
Yeah, tell me about these guys playing with you. What an amazing band.
My band, I know, they're the best, they're the best. So Michael, the bass player, and I have played together in the past in a couple bands, and he's played with me before. I've known him for like 3.5 years now. And then Trey Pollard, it was the producer, co-producer, and string arranger on the record that we released on guitar. And then Scott Clark on drums is like this amazing free jazz kind of player. And yeah, he's awesome.
But I felt you have fine experience playing live, being on stage. So you had some other bands before?
Yeah, I've done all sorts of stuff. I mean, I've played drums in bands, I've played bass, I played keyboards with Jenny Lewis all last year. So yeah, I've been on stage doing all sorts of things. Yeah.
What did you start doing, like playing guitar, writing songs, and when?
Yeah, I wrote my first song in first grade. You know, my family's not like a musical family or anything, but my dad is, you know, loves music and he'll write songs, but it's very, you know, it's rare. You know, that's not what he does for his living or anything, but he's just a very eccentric person, and that's definitely where I get it from. But so when I have this very strong memory, my dad was just like playing guitar on the couch, and I ran. I'm like, "What are you? Like, what song is that? It's so great." And he's like, "Oh, I'm just making it up." And I was like, "Oh, cool! Like, people can make up songs." And so then I started making up my own songs in first grade and never stopped. So, yeah.
So it was like kind of a. Did you study music?
I did. I went to Berklee College of Music for 1 year. Got a scholarship to go there, but then I hated Boston, so I left. And then I went to school in Nashville, and I finished up there for songwriting. But I've never taken like proper lessons, though. I just play by ear.
So it was kind of a dual education. Your father with really good taste of music, but yeah, like specific and studying music. Yes.
Yeah. It's just kind of like I knew. I've always been really passionate about it. I've always loved music, and it's all I think about and want to do. And so I never like took proper lessons. But when I was growing up, I was just like, I want to do this, and I just did it. Like I started a band, and when I was 12, and didn't stop from there. And like didn't really know what I was doing, you know, because Virginia Beach, where I grew up, is not very like a music town or anything, but. I just knew I had to do it, and I was the only girl in bands, like the only girl playing an instrument, you know, and with a whole bunch of dudes, you know, and that's still my life, you know. I'm happy that there's more girls in my life now playing music, but you know, it's just meet a bunch of dudes.
When did you notice that it was like the right time and the right moment to start something as Natalie Press?
Well, I mean, I've been doing that. I've been doing that, you know, since I started, but I've always kind of just had side projects, just because I just like to stay excited about what I'm doing, and I felt like it was really good for me to get outside of my head, to play for other people, like, learn their music, and, but I always knew, like, I need to do my own thing, But I joined Jenny Lewis's band last year. But even though I had like this record recorded and other records recorded, but like I don't mind playing for other people. I think it's really fun, and I learn a lot about myself and what other people do. So I'll probably join a band next year. Who knows?
We've had enough. Matthew E. White was like a kind of an inspiration for you and an important guy to these debut album.
Big time. What's so special about Matt and I is we grew up in Virginia Beach together. And like in this big world, and I was living in Nashville, and like here we are, like we're totally, you know, really good friends, and we made like the really great record together. Like I never would have thought that when I first met him when I was like 14, you know, that we would be here now together, you know. But I just really believed in what he was doing. It was right on the money, as far as direction of where I wanted to go with my full-length record. In Nashville, nobody was really picking up what I was talking about when I was looking for a producer. And Matt and I got put in touch by a mutual friend, and it was just like instantly like, okay, cool, we're on the same page. And it felt more meaningful to me to go back home to Virginia and work with like an old friend, you know? And that's what we did, and it worked.
I would really like to see songs of you both singing
playing
together.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you have any demos or something, any tries?
We haven't done that. We like tried to write together once way back in the day. I've sang with him on stage a couple times, but no, nice. We should do that. Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah. And you have a lot of new songs written. No, are you thinking release something like soon?
Yeah, well, it's, you know, I have a lot of songs that I've written up until January, and from really January on to this point, I've been nonstop on the road, and it's really hard, I've discovered it's really, really hard for me to write when I'm just constantly bouncing around, you know, and I write in fragments, you know, and I'm the kind of writer where I like to have my safe space, and just, I can just, you know, but then once I'm in the groove, like, I can't stop, and so, but I need to be in one spot, you know, but the goal is, you know, we're done in December, and then I have 2 months off, and I'm just gonna write, and demo, and then hopefully have a record ready in May, but to release in the fall or something, so,
yeah. So, but do you consider the possibility to write songs while on the road? It's something that can be possible for you?
I mean, I can try, but I honestly think you also need some life experience. Like, when your life is like a van, four dudes, playing shows, hotel, every single day, yeah. You know, it's really, I don't know, that's not like brain fuel. That's not, you're not getting any real, like, life experience, like, you know what I mean? Or you don't have any time to stop and think about what is happening to you, really. So, I try, you know, I write a lot of melodies, I have a ton of melodies, but no, it's really hard for me, and, so.
You are playing a lot. Everywhere.
A lot, yeah, a lot. Yeah, and it's just.
Which is good, because yeah. it's a sign that your record was really, really something good.
Yeah. Thanks. That's good. Yeah, but like 2 days into touring, you know, and I bring everything that I need to write. I'm like, this tour, I'm gonna do it, you know. And but then like 2 days into tour, you're like, oh, you're like, how long till I sleep again? You know. Yeah.
Okay, so you need to rest. Right. Thank you so much.
Yeah, you are
really kind. Thank you.
Oh, you are too.